themselves months and months later. So is there any plans or any provision to follow this up on a personal individual basis that residents will have the opportunity to speak to anyone rather than just our community?
Yeah, thank you, Councillor Jones. That question has been discussed, but I just think to add to that conversation, really. I went to a meeting with Councillor Bird and a number of the affected residents, and it was a moving experience, I have to say, because as an officer who's responded to an incident, doing the best of his abilities, I accept that people have been affected in different ways, and those effects will happen at different times during that response and recovery for that individual or that family. So I took away a phrase that was raised to me at that meeting, which was maybe we didn't quite get right, the victim's voice. Now, in mitigation towards some of that, I would say, you're absolutely right, we used as a conduit to communicate the whole range of people those public meetings. But I know, myself included, but other officers, and certainly David Ball, gave his mobile number out to every person through all of those and said, if there is anything that needs to be discussed with anybody, do not bother, you know, going through the council system, give me a ring personally. And he made that on a number of occasions, and I know I did. So, in some ways, you're right, we need to look at a system and a process that allows and caters for incidents of that nature where latent recovery from mental health trauma is right, and that's conversations with our health professionals to ensure that they're part of that. And I absolutely accept that as a learning point out of this. We've taken some of that away in terms of the review and the paperwork, and there are reviews that are taking place in terms of city regions, new plans around those issues. But the other point for me is that I think in terms of Wirral officers, yeah, that have responded to that site, I gave my card out, my individual telephone number out to a whole host of people and said, as I would in any incident, in any recovery, that if you've been affected, you need to give me a bell, and I will make sure that something gets to you. Now, in some cases, that's some residents weren't in a position to be able to either one, receive that communication or understand that they might not be present. It might not be right for them. The 2 weeks might not have been a window that actually succumbed to those. They may be people who witnessed it rather than actually experienced it firsthand with damage. But we need to make sure we're clear that if people are suffering through any contact with the council, that we pick that up and take that forward to help those individuals.
Yeah, I do the same, particularly with some young people who live in the flats above the shops. Maybe it's because of my background, they seem particularly vulnerable and trying to offer special support to them as well.
Okay. Joe.
Yeah. Thanks. One of the things that's concerned me as we have this conversation is that these recommendations that you rightly referred to were, you know, 18 months or 27 months ago, that's when they were recommended in those debrief reports on both phases. And what I'm not really hearing is what changes have been made as a result of the council's own recommendations. For example, so it does say here to ensure there's arrangements for community engagement, but what we're hearing is just ad hoc meetings. There isn't any systematic engagement with the community, there isn't any systematic offering of one-to-one support for people who are suffering trauma. I don't think it's appropriate just for the owners to be on the victim to call the mobile phone number. And also you didn't actually address the point that particularly vulnerable victims who struggle with English, that question was raised about translation interpretation. Children respond differently to adults, all those kinds of questions I don't see being implemented as a result of the recommendations.
So, I think the experience itself, in terms of leading this experience for those officers who are involved, will bring about some of those changes. So when you're saying that we need to have an engagement, there was an engagement team down in that area, and there's still engagement officers in that area. Ferguson and the team are still in place down in wasn't aware until the meeting with Councillor Bird and those half dozen or so residents there, that actually there were people who still weren't engaged in it. I came back in February with some of that information back into the system.
Yeah, and then what?
This is part of that process in terms of that engagement, isn't it? It's coming back. I'm struggling to understand how more, and I'm saying this in an open and honest way, accepting the members will have views, but if there's a requirement for a specific engagement plan on the back of any instance we have, I think we executed an engagement plan. It might not necessarily be written down, but there were officers on the ground, there were facilities available, there were meetings in place where the public and the residents were invited to. If that didn't meet the criteria or for every individual, then we need to look at that and understand how best we can do that in future.
I think the other thing it would be remiss not to say this actually gets harder as the life changes around us. So, you know, if this had happened a decade ago, the council would have had 3,000 more staff to assist in some ways. It would have been easier in terms of school organisation if you go back prior to the current setup, because we would have had instant access to every school, every sports hall, which we don't have now, because we're all but I think it's one of our high schools, our academy trusts, but we have no access whatever. So I think these things do not get easier to organise, they get more challenging really. The key thing is that we turn out to these events, we're not in charge of them when we get to them, we make sure we do what we can to aid deal with immediate risks, to support the people who are in charge of it, and then we do everything we can to help the people that are involved. And I think this was a totally different circumstance than what we normally face. We did do our very best to respond, both on the night, but also in the weeks that followed. And the council shifted resource from one place to another, because that's what it has to do these days.
Skills strategy, extensive work taking place in developing the world skills strategy. chair of the Wilmette College, who's the lead on that strategy. We've been working with the City Region in terms of the adult education budget as well. So in April 2019, the LCR Combined Authority agreed to accept a grant allocation of £50 million from the Department of Education in respect of the bold LCR adult education budget. So again, as an authority, we've been working with the CA over the last 6 months about rural allocation, which will be ring-fenced by the community learning division for residents aged 19 plus this coming year. So again, quite a lot of activity in that workforce, skills, business needs one, but it is a bit more intangible in terms of capturing that information, but it is as stated in the report. In terms of thriving small businesses, our appointed engagement organisation of the business community is the Royal Chamber of Commerce. They continue to overachieve on their targets within the business contract which we have with them. Town centre funding, mayoral funds and future high street funds. So we've received some positive news in terms of New Ferry and Liscard for the LCR mayoral funds, an allocation of £4.5 million each of those areas. And we've also progressed with the future high street allocations for New Ferry and the Birkenhead area as well, with all business cases being drawn up as we speak. And then there was also work progressed on the New Ferry master plan as well, which was covered in the previous report.
perspective of whether you take any apprenticeships or not, and it does to a certain extent stop any other adult learning going on because of that.
In terms of specific
like capital expenditure for business was 7.2 million, which changed from a projection of 4 to 3 of 6.2 million. And there was a few reasons for this difference. The main one was because one of the main capital programmes was the Windows 10 rollouts, and part of that was implemented ahead of what was originally planned. And the reason for this is because if we bought laptops in the old year, then we'd be able to get them at cheaper rates before the fees went up in future years, and we brought part of the capital programme forward and saved money as a result of this against the Windows 10 project overall. And the 7.2 million of spend, that mainly consisted of ICT spend, so there's Windows 10 expenditure, storage expenditure, and the other main part of the capital expenditure was early voluntary retirement and severance costs. So I'll just talk through the main reasons of the main cost of capital expenditure. By the end of March 2019, there's a total of 1,002 Windows 10 devices that have been deployed. That was 29% completion of the estimated goal across the whole authority. The progress originally was like being targeted at priority groups first to get new service programs and new Windows 10 machines. And this included children's social care, senior managers, counselors, and new service programs first. And then the rest of Windows 10 was rolled out across the authority. And also, in the last financial year, was the creation of the application store, the deployment of software and work smart profiling, for the determination of software. And then the other main expenditure against capital, in addition to Windows 10, was within ICT as well, which was the core of the storage solution. And this will eventually replace Wirral's existing storage and virtual server network. And it was going to be implemented mainly throughout the first and second quarters of 2019, but we spent part of it, the original upfront expenditure came at the very end of the 2018-19 capital programme. That was the main part of what we spent against capital. But then, in addition to this, there was EVR and severance costs in 2018-19 as a result of employees that could leave the authority. So with severance payments and 5-year pensions
within agricultural. What do you have those targets, or can they be presented to this committee so we can see who is meeting targets and who aren't?
Yeah, I know some of them. Some of them have been meeting
up to
you with
the
information.
While I'm doing the bits, could we have it just in one big sort of report, a list of what's being met and who isn't meeting and who is meeting? No, it was just so that's so what I'm saying is does that not consist? No, it sort of doesn't. Does it? Yeah. I was going to say, so if you went out and bought a tractor to rake the beach in Hoylake, that'd be a good example. And we managed to spend £100,000 less that by negotiating, that would be attributed as a capital saving. But if we had to borrow the money to buy that set tractor and managed to get it for 1% instead of 2%, attributed that as a revenue spend and saving, yeah. Am I saying that correctly?
Except
you just repeat it. Okay, I'll take the flippant factor of our notes. So say we were spending X amount on something.
Does it
include
pieces of revenue?
Yeah.
Just
why it's proposing with it,
is it? Yeah, it does have a program. So the same capital program, that overall capital finance program, which is a £6 million a year, what's in the report is the business management section. Okay. So think about it. There's a £7 million program, and having financed that means cheap finance, etc., gives quite substantial saving. And what's done within the report is the MS business management. And that includes a reprofile. So we've brought some stuff in from 1920 into 1819. So we've brought it forward. So you could say it's never spending. It's kind of reprofiling.
Right.
On the other way, some projects have been moved the other way. So 1819 we've gone into 1920.
Right.
Yeah, is that okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chair. Thanks, Sarah. Just one question on page 56. When we went all digital, all these you said these pros, we were told it was going to save a lot of money on printing. Yeah, one of the shortfalls now is from the printing department because of the reduction of work. Is there a correlation between the two, or is that something entirely different?
I think it's like there's partly a correlation between the two, but there's also different reasons as to why that's reduced. Because like stop printing paper.
item 7, City Region.
Serious on that with regard to the ports. So clearly one of the things that I've been announced is that free ports are going to be one of the first strategies for the government if no deal with Brexit does come about. It's still happening in that, by the way. Clearly we've had free ports in to the side of the walls before. What can we do to be looking to see if there's anything that we could get some of that investment and some of those opportunities on our side of the water as well?
On that, can I ask if we have discussions with the people of Holland, because they are most of the leading ports from here,
Fizzy Marsh,
who's in Manchester, what's further up the coast?
So there's a debate of the city region at the moment, and the Metro Mayor's office about what the impact of the three ports would be. So if it was just purely on a movement of goods, then I don't think we're looking to favourably as a combined authority on what impact that would be. If there was some added value processes of looking at bringing goods into the ports, using them in the assembly process, I think
that's a
good status. I think there'll be added value at what policy stage in the combined authority moment. But my understanding is that we are looking at expressing interest on some of the other major ports to go in that situation.
Because it's almost like we've got tens of thousands of potential square foot down in one of our dock areas that could actually be used for that, isn't it? We might give him a good time.
Yeah. I'll move forward a strong moment on that basis, which I'm planning to do to have a conversation.
We've actually got 2 million, but most of you know where this happened.
Hi there, thank you. Thanks very much indeed. Yeah, it's just in relation to, I've certainly been putting it in the bus end, but I'm just wondering, as officers, what inputs we're fussing into the Metro Mayor and the point of view of housing stores.
So we collaborate on the